The governor of the province of Ulyanovsk, Putin's man, has issued a proclamation. From now on, September 12th of every year is officially the day of conception. Don't laugh, you're being culturally insensitive. Under the terms of the proclamation, on September 12th, all workers are given the afternoon off with orders, I'm quoting the proclamation, with orders to go home and create a patriot for Russia. This strikes me as not a brilliant idea.
But
June 12th is officially the day of birth, by the way.
Yeah, June 12th is official day of birth. And why did they choose September the 12th?
I wasn't in the room when they made that decision. I haven't the slightest idea.
I see.
By the way, in Spain, where they have an even lower birth rate, they've made it illegal to use the words mother and father on a birth certificate because they're sexist. The official words on a Spanish birth certificate are progenitor A and progenitor B, because they're interchangeable.
Interesting. Kerry.
Can you talk about the birth rates of other civilizations, like the Muslims, and their ability to assimilate into Western civilization?
When you look around the world, the Muslim countries have the highest birth rates. They go from the 2.1 replacement level up to about 6.8, varying very widely from country to country. So that's where the growth is coming from. All through the advanced world, if you will, Western civilization, the birth rates are below the replacement level. They vary from country to country, but they're all below it. When you look at the Muslim countries, they're all above it. So that's where the population shift is.
Well, in many cases, you would see a direct correlation between societies which are becoming, let's just say, more entrepreneurial, more wealthy, and then the lowering of the birth rate. Is that likely to happen in Muslim societies, or is there something in Islam that's likely not to make
that work? Well, we don't know. Obviously, when you move into the modern world, you tend to have fewer children. Women are working. The way we live today, driving around, going to Disney World on vacations, things like that. So it's not a surprise that the birth rates have gone down a bit. What no one saw is that they would drop off a cliff. By the way, the birth rate in India is 2.8. The birth rate in China is 1.1. China is now the most rapidly aging country in the world.
Wait, yes,
which
ma'am.
Will kill them, by the way.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Being a Russian, I can't but comment on what you said about Russia. I certainly don't agree about what you said about Putin, but I'm not going to speak about that right now.
He's a thug.
Pardon?
He's a thug.
I don't agree, but I'm not going
to
comment
on that.
Tell
the people he murdered, but go right ahead.
I was going to comment on what you said about our birth rate. Certainly, the demographic situation is very bad. You said you spoke about this funny, you know, law that they introduced. Yes, it's probably nice to show Russians as clowns. But what you haven't mentioned is that the federal government, has recently introduced a law according to which each family which gives birth to a second child gets a very substantial, by Russian standard, amount of money that you haven't mentioned.
We haven't gotten to that. They have done that, and that is a very good thing to do. They're doing that in France, too. What they're trying to do is build up the birth rate. And what they've recognized is that the most likely person to have another child is someone who already has a child. In other words, if you have one or two children, you're more likely to have a third rather than a 32-year-old woman who's never been married having one. And so they're putting in financial incentives to have additional children, and that's a good thing.
Unfortunately, I have let us get way too close to time to get to the third one. That's the internal threat that you're talking about. Tell us about that.
Well, that's what we call the cultural war in the United States, and it's kind of become a second civil war. And it really revolves around the role of church and state. The shorthand version is the religious right versus the secular left, but you know that's sort of unfair to both sides when you say it that way. It really gets into the question of whether the family will be the center of our lives or the government will be the center of our lives. Who raises the kids? I mean, that really is the crux of it, no matter how you look. It gets into the question of whether you want a larger government or a smaller government. What should be the role of government? You know, politics is the relationship between the individual and the state. It's not Democrats versus Republicans or liberals versus conservatives. And the Second Civil War really comes out to what should be the proper relationship between the individual and the state.
Well, all that would have maybe sounded good before George W. was elected 7-8 years ago, but here's a guy who's grown the state more than anybody since LBJ. What do you make of that?
It's true he has. I mean, what can one say? You know, that wasn't
maybe he's
that
really
wasn't
maybe
what
Al
a lot
Gore
of people expected
maybe
him to
Al
do.
Gore was really elected in Florida and nobody knew it. Maybe that's what happened.
Well,
do you think? Let
me stay out of that one.
Okay.
But what you're really seeing here, and by the way, you're quite right, there is a fracture within the Republican Party because much of what we've seen in the last years, the spending and things like that, is on the other side of that cultural divide.
Now, I wouldn't imagine that the folks you're talking about, whether they happen to be liberal or Democrat or neither or what, I mean, most of those folks are pretty nice folks too, I would imagine, in general. I don't think that they don't have a platform, whether it's a party platform or an organizational platform that says we're out to destroy Western civilization. So why do you say they're doing that?
Well, to some extent, we've forgotten what Western civilization is. You'd be hard-pressed to find a lot of instructors or teachers who teach what it is. And by the way, when you look at schools around the United States, in Europe, in Japan, and by the way, there are wonderful exceptions to this, here in Texas and other places as well. Mostly what they're teaching the kids is that the worst thing that ever happened to planet Earth is humanity. We pollute, we use resources. Teach that to kids for 15 years, they grow up and they think that bringing a baby into the world is committing a hostile act against the planet. Surprise, birth rates drop. So to some extent, we're doing this to ourselves.
Yeah. Well, it certainly sounds entertaining. And just the few seconds that we have left, I want to tell that person watching this program that you really need to watch part two to figure out what we're going to do about these things and whether you agree with them, because now, you know, whether you agree with the three challenges that Herb Meyer has laid out or not, I think you will agree that they pose some important questions about the future of this country as well as Europe. Our hope is that we have helped you understand these issues better and that you'll continue to educate yourself on them in the future, because as you know, the future is going to be what we make it. Join us next week for part two when we discuss what to do about the challenges. Thanks for inviting us in to talk about things that matter with people who care.
If you would like to purchase a DVD or video of this program for $20 plus $5 postage and handling, and in Texas, applicable tax, call 214-442-1600 or email info@frtv.org. Visit McCuistion on the web at www.frtv.org. Production of McCuistion is made possible in part by individual viewers, the Hatton W. Sumner's Foundation for the Study of Teaching and Self-Government, Hillcrest Foundation founded by Mrs. W.W. Caruth Sr., CF & Company LLP, serving Dallas-Fort Worth and the Southwest since 1956, and Sundown Ranch, providers of comprehensive and co-occurring disorder treatment to adolescents and young adults.